A window left open in that weather? Perhaps something had to be watched. The spirograph amused Carl. It was a nice modern toy. Aside from being repetitive by nature and completely useless, still, it found its way into many Quebecois homes. Well, looks like someone woke up on the wrong side of the bed. Carl's big fingers prevented him from reaching the key. Carl's big fingers prevented him from reaching. Carl's big fingers prevented him from reaching the key. The track was fresh. That meant the car sunk down just a little while ago. Now, where the hell could the passengers possibly have gone? Someone must have dropped this in a hurry, but whoever did was heading into the woods. Carl's tracking instincts were quickly kicking in. Carl felt engulfed by a wave of cold, and for a second thought he was fainting. All of a sudden, four phantasmagoric figures were fixing their gaze on him. What the hell was going on? The further Carl moved away from the ice block, the more his senses came back to him. Carl knew why he was suddenly shivering. He was going back to the realm of visions. Carl sensed that the cold was beating a retreat, as if he was moving away from some kind of center of gravity. Carl's big finger. papers prevented him from reaching the key. There was only void where the road should be. Carl hated dead ends. He felt trapped. It was as if the road had drowned in the lake. He would have to find help by another road. Welcome to Alibaba's Cave, Lumberjack Edition. Surely Carl would find something worth his time in here. Someone had been playing with a crossbow here. A very dangerous game. A bolt could hit someone's tire, or their eye. It could even kill someone if the aim was right. Without a single window to brighten things up, the inside of the cabin was almost pitch black. Beware of close encounters of knee and furniture. Everything was set up for a well-deserved snack. It seemed like the place hadn't been empty for long, but without knowing exactly why, Carl had the feeling no one was coming back anytime soon.
Solitaire, a card game only hermits can truly enjoy. Carl felt depressed at the thought of playing this.
But a steak alone cannot subdue a starving stomach. An appetite comes with eating. But a steak alone cannot subdue a starving stomach. An appetite comes with eating. The air was freezing, right down to the bone. Carl felt a cool, tingling sensation in his back. Another vision took over him. Something was hidden under the stairs. The man grabbed his rifle. Carl felt a sense of dread in him. Perhaps their spousal relationship had been cooling down lately. It seemed like secrecy was commonplace in this house. Carl felt the cold slowly dissipate and was brought back to reality. Giselle was now only ice, and all that was left of her voice was a diary. She confided in this diary, amongst other things, the tragic story of a young woman, a victim. Was this what she was hiding?
Looks like the holes in that puzzle are there to stay. The pot was cold, and the stew inside wasn't cooked. It's likely that poor Giselle was slow cooking it before she got snapped. What a waste. Ah, moving. What a pleasant activity. Of course, you'll find the record player only to find the records weeks later in some random box. Carl had seen that kind of safe before. With its double-layered security system blending letters and numbers, its code couldn't be broken by the common burglar. The general store, along with several more infrastructures in the area, had been acquired by wealthy industrialist William J. Hamilton. Perhaps the village should be rechristened Hamiltown. What a mess! Clearly, there was some major revamping work underway here. The place looked barely habitable. Beautiful portrait of Gilles and Giselle, bound together by the chains of conventional love. A nice white coating would restore the room to its charm of olden days. Many boxes scattered about. Carl didn't need to summon his detective training to quickly figure that the LaChances had just moved in. Thank you. Carl was no burglar. He didn't need to resort to petty techniques such as window breaking to find his way in. A good detective simply looks for keys where gullible souls hide them. What was even the point of locking your door if everyone hid their key in the same place? Carl was starting to feel like his investigator life lacked challenge. The house smelled like incense, the kind that reminds you of the good Lord, of peace. Religion was very influential throughout Quebec many years ago. Indeed, it was surprising that Carl did not come across a single chapel since arriving here. The family's mother must have spent her days washing the filth off her kids' diapers. The empty cradle sent an eerie feeling down Carl's spine, as if minutes ago someone just grabbed the baby and made a run for it. Who knew that giraffes thrived in the North Pole? The craze for toys was stupefying. Love of religion and ancestors was rooted deep inside the hearts of Canadians of old, to which the Bedards appeared to be closely related. Carl wasn't desperate enough to invade a village woman's privacy. Carl wasn't desperate enough to invade a village woman's privacy. Jean-Luc Bedard had without a doubt been the closest man in the village to William Hamilton, otherwise known as Uncle Willie. Carl smiled at the sight of the nicely protected garden. Hopefully, the Bedards had managed to dig every last potato out before the sudden snowfall. A true Catholic always strives to keep lowly temptations at bay. Obviously, Carl thought, someone in this house wasn't doing a good job at upholding the Holy Bible's teachings. Carl, like many of his contemporaries, felt like he had more trouble breathing when he wasn't smoking. Cigarette was his own personal breathing assistant. The perfect cookie-cutter Catholic family, most likely attending church every Sunday.